Hi, my name is Kacper.
I'm Phil.
We're the Grill Bastards.
And today we're going to teach you how to grill the perfect steak.
On a gas grill.
On a charcoal grill.
You make your own steak on a charcoal grill, I make mine on a gas grill. We'll see the difference.
All right, let's go.
What do you say, some oil? Or you
nope.
Don't need it?
Nope. I don't need it. Really? It's going to burn, man.
Okay.
All you need is
whatever.
Salt.
Whatever. Salt, yeah, this is something I will agree with. Some mold on salt. But man, you're putting too much salt, it will be too salty.
It's gonna be sweet.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay,
are you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Did you put pepper on yours?
I could.
It's gonna burn, but I guess.
Sure. No, it won't. We'll see. We'll see about that.
I'm doing no oil, salt only, and I'm gonna put this stuff like the real man that I am. I don't need no metal, I don't need no grill. I just need fire.
Whoa. Yeah, right. Right here I have a very special burner. It's called Sizzle Zone. Take a look at this. Over 800 degrees. How's your charcoal doing?
It's nice and sweet. I'm gonna leave it on the side for a little bit longer. You know why? I got time.
It's like,
I'm a caveman today.
It looks like a poor man's dinner.
It's my day off. It's my day off. I'm not gonna be spending time.
Take a look at this. Beautiful caramelization. It took me 20 seconds. Dude.
That looks cooked.
Okay, whatever. I'm flipping it to the other side.
That's caramelized.
Okay.
Yeah, smell it. It smells like burnt meat the real way. I just hunted this.
Okay, look at this. It's the same.
It's cooked. It's cooked. I could boil potatoes that are gonna be more tender than that.
Dude, my method is really precise. I know exactly what time do I need to make it perfectly caramelized.
Too much focus. This is your day off. You're supposed to grill, not spend all this time. Look, I'm gonna do some stretches.
Dude.
If we would have more space, I would do some lunges, but come on.
Dude, take a look at this. This is precise work. You know, I'm a professional chef. I need to be precise. I need to do everything, you know, like it's supposed to be done. Thermometer, dude.
Dude,
how is it even done?
Dude, we work together.
I know.
We do this every day. But why today, of all days, can't we just... Look, come on. You know what? This is...
Okay. I gotta tell you, looks good. But anyway, take a look at this. I have a precise temperature control. Here is where I have very high temperature. Here is where I have very low temperature. Here is where I put my perfectly made steak. Now it's gonna cook to perfection. What do you say?
What are you gonna do yours, medium rare? Please do a medium.
Okay, we'll do medium.
I'm gonna do a slight medium well because I like opening up that fat in the middle, because otherwise, what's the point of grilling a fatty piece of meat? But I'm gonna let this rest a little bit and then I'm gonna do a re-sear.
Wow, sounds like a really sophisticated method for you.
Yeah, I guess. Look, the lighter was the most complex things of today's day. So, it's our day off.
Okay. Dude, you know you have some wood in here.
Oh yeah, I should have smoked that.
Can I borrow that?
Yeah.
Okay. See, this is how it works. Now I'm gonna have it smoked already.
Are you still cooking your steak?
Yeah, I am. 36 degrees Celsius inside. Internal temperature. What do you say? What's yours? Let's see. Let's use some Jedi forces.
Fuck. Oh, that's good. That's good.
This is like 26 degrees.
If it's as warm as you, baby, then it's I'm good to go.
Okay.
But I'm gonna give them look. I'm gonna give them a little bit of double sear and a little bit more smoke in my eyes. Remember, smoke in the eyes. If you don't have smoke in the eyes, you're not grilling. So, do you have smoke?
Yeah, almost.
Oh, you had to borrow my smoke.
Yeah.
Yeah. So okay. So you're grilling because you got to borrow.
I have a smoke. Thank you.
And look at that. We're going to just sear that on the bottom.
Nice. What do you say? Can I borrow that?
Yeah.
Okay, sure.
And I guess since it's my day off and I'm lazy and I don't want to double sear this, I'm just going to put this charcoal right here.
Yeah, dude, check it out.
Yeah, same thing. See? Great mind things alike. Great minds think alike, even if they're opposing forces, see?
Yeah, let's be honest. Both methods are cool.
I know this is barbaric and people are probably like, what are you doing? You can make a little fire pit and do the same thing. We're doing this in the grill because
it's 2023. You know how expensive the charcoal is? And my propane gas
we get
still cheaper.
Really?
Yeah, I think so. Although, I'm not sure.
Okay, let's not get into economics right now with this, because this is a bad choice, but yeah.
I'm going to tell you how it looks. It looks like a pork neck that my uncle used to make in the 90s in Poland. Whole burnt, black and dry. Mine will be perfect. 42 degrees, dude.
Mine will have flavor.
Yeah, whatever.
I'd rather have a tasty steak than a perfectly cooked steak.
Take a look at this. This is my aroma. This is my charcoal aroma. Stolen from you.
Yeah, and it's gonna be on the top. I have that all the way through. And I can eat mine probably sooner.
Yeah, whatever.
It's my day off.
Ready?
I'm gonna rest them a little bit.
Okay. Mine will be ready in like 2 minutes 36 seconds.
Plus 5 minutes resting.
Yeah, exactly.
Plus the wind.
Oh, I'm surprised you're resting your steak. I thought you were gonna chew into it immediately after, you know, grilling it.
Because I wanted you to enjoy at least a nice piece of it also.
Okay.
If it was just for me, I'd probably do that. But I will season it right now a little bit. There's the whole season your desk, your cutting board thing, you do the same thing. Sometimes you just, if you're lazy, you just go like that, and then you just go, and then the steak has that stuff going in there, and you don't have to touch it. I guess cook smart, not hard. Yeah, you season your cutting board, so we already seasoned mine pretty heavily. But if you like to, you know, just slightly season your steak, you're gonna leave it somewhere to rest. So you just season the toppings, so you can put like parsley, garlic, some Parmesan. And then you just put your steak on that, you leave it there for a resting time, and then you have a sauce, I guess, if you're lazy.
Sloppy kind of sauce. Actually, you can try your steak first, then we'll go for mine.
You want hot sauce?
Yeah.
All right. We're gonna get hot
sauce. But first, let's try the beef itself.
All right. So.
Yeah, always remember that ribeye contains of two muscles, one from the outside and one from the inside. Ribeye cut. This is the delicious part of ribeye. So I'm going for that. Is there enough salt in there?
Yeah, it's definitely enough salt.
Okay. Can we go with the ribeye cut?
That's a medium, medium well.
Mm-hmm. I know you like this doneness. And I gotta tell you, I'm buying it. Really crunchy, dude.
It's charcoal, but
my shit's gonna be really healthy tomorrow. It really tastes like my uncle's pork neck from the 90s. It's really that. But I love it. Look, man, it's ready. Right now it's medium. Well, it's gonna be medium well as requested in 3 to 4 minutes.
That took a lot of time though. We already ate my steak.
Okay. I'm gonna finish it up.
Yeah, I guess.
Mine is a dessert steak.
Ah, yeah.
Precisely done, juicy dessert steak.
But mine has burnt ends. Yeah, I'm gonna give you another piece of burnt end with a little bit of fat. Look, oh, this is what it's all about. Oh. I know it doesn't look pretty. It's all black.
I really enjoy your steak.
And burnt.
I gotta say.
But
mine is cooked to perfection. So, what I always do with ribeyes, I cut the external muscle in order to try my perfection, because this is perfection, man. Take a look at this. Take a look at this.
Ooh, that's a nice medium well. That's a medium, medium well. Looks nice and...
As requested.
All right, I might not make fun of you for boiling your meat today now, but let's see how it tastes.
I think it's enough salty. Could you give me some pepper, please? To my perfect steak. So, go ahead, try my steak. Juicy, cooked to perfection. What do you say?
I'm not gonna say it's better, but it is as good. But the one downside is, it took you a hell of a long time.
Guys, both of these steaks are great, really.
Yeah.
This one's juicy, cooked to perfection with thermometer, but Philip's steak has something special. has fire.
It has fire. We need more
fire. It has this really beautiful taste of people gathering around fire and spending some time together and just grilling.
Yeah, man. Well, you can still do that on a propane grill. I guess it's just easier, but yeah.
Take care, guys.